Hello everyone, this is Princescyther and jennabunnykins for VGgameplay. Hello Jenna.
Hello me.
We're playing Jak and Daxter on the Jak and Daxter collection for the PS3. See, they've actually updone his graphics there. He actually looks better than he does in the game itself.
It's a bit annoying.
But yeah, it's a bit weird how he didn't do that. I guess they would have had to recreate the whole model though, but whatever, let's go.
Who has time for that?
Who has time for that?
Not this guy.
So, me and Jenna recently played through all these games, including the PSP game. We didn't play Daxter, did we? The Daxter game. Although, I've heard that's quite good, but I do have it, but I don't have a PSP, so I can't play it. But we did play the other PSP game. What was it? Lost Frontier.
Mm-hmm.
Which is kind of the fourth one, I guess. And Jak X. Played Jak X as well. But this is our favourite.
Nothing beats the Precursor Legacy.
Jak and Daxter, the Precursor Legacy. Although you do have to change the horizontal controls because they're backwards. Although it says flipped for me, even though that's not true.
Maybe you're backwards.
Not true. Maybe I'm backwards, yeah. When I press left, I want the camera to go left, not right. Doesn't make sense. Saving data.
I have spent my life searching for the answers that my father and my father's fathers failed to find. Who were the precursors? Why did they create the vast monoliths that litter our planet? How did they harness eco, the life energy of the world? What was their purpose? And why did they vanish? I have asked the plants, but they do not remember. The plants have asked the rocks. But the rocks do not recall. Even the rocks do not recall. Every bone in my body tells me that the answers rest on the shoulders of a young boy. Oblivious to his destiny, uninterested in the search for truth, and rejecting
this bushel head puking over the side.
Little bushel head.
Why would he want to listen to old Samus the Sage anyway? I'm only the master of green ego. So it seems the answer begins not with careful research or sensible thinking.
We're skating on ice.
As with many of fate's
disobedience,
it begins with but a small act.
That you're gonna start speaking like Yoda.
All green stuff.
Disobedient, you will be.
He's not well, is he?
Deal harshly with anybody who strays from the village. We will attack it in due time.
You're obsessed with breasts, you're. Whenever we play a game that's got breasts visible, you go, breasts! Breasts, Mike, look, breasts! Breasts, there, look! Look, you're missing them!
From one female to another, I can admire.
This place gives me the creeps!
That's some dark eco.
Go play it out.
Oh, stupid precursor junk.
It's alright.
What is that dark ooze? It sure doesn't look friendly. The sage yaps on about the precursors that built this place all the time.
Where did they go? Why did they build this crap?
Now, I like precursor orbs and power cells as much as the next guy. But if you ask me, they must have been real losers. Wow! How did you do that? I think we're in trouble!
Uh-oh.
Man, that scum! I told you we shouldn't have come here!
Here comes the scream!
What?
The Wilhelm scream?
What? Okay,
Okay. Yeah, is he covering his ears?
I'm fine.
He's not fine.
How's no one else found him? Screaming like that.
What in green tarnation do you two want?
We was...
Don't tell me! Instead of heeding my wisdom, the two of you went mucking around in the only place that I told you not to go. Misty Island.
That's right. And
Daxter, you finally took a much-needed bath, but in a bathtub filled with dark eco.
Look, old man, are you gonna keep yapping, or are you gonna help me out of this mess?
I'm gonna keep yapping, because in my professional opinion, the change is an improvement. And besides, I couldn't help you if I wanted to.
What?
There's only one person who has studied Dark Eco long enough to have a chance at returning you to your previous form. Karl Acheron, the Sage. But he lives far to the north. Far, far to the north. Nobody has spoken to him in ages.
He's over there somewhere.
But I can't do that either. None of the three sages that maintain the other teleporter gates have seen fit to turn their ends on for quite a while.
Useless.
The only other way north is by foot through the Fire Canyon, but its volcanic soil is hot enough to melt precursor metal. You can't just walk through it.
But you could fly over it if you had a zoomer equipped with a heat shield.
Rests.
I just happen to be working on such a thing at this very moment.
Let it go.
All I would need is 20 power cells to give it enough energy to withstand the canyon's heat. Isn't that right, Daddy?
Yes, Kira.
Why was she pointing at Daxter?
But we're a boy and a half.
Oh, she's confused.
Going to get 20 power cells.
From the villagers. Most of them have a power cell or two stashed away somewhere. And even if they aren't willing to just give them away, greasing their palms with a few precursor orbs should do the trick. And I bet there are even more of them out in the wilds just waiting for some brave adventurer to find.
Well, we've got the brave adventurer at least.
Brave adventurer? You two couldn't find your way out of the village without training. Before you do anything else, you better
go to the
warp gate and get some practice on Geyser Rock.
We won't find any more of that dark gooey eco stuff, will we? Cause I'd hate to fall in again and turn into you.
Get in there! Before I turn you both into ferns!
Looks like he shaves his arms.
How is he hanging upside down?
Magic.
I just realized he was floating around the place. How's he doing that? Okay, so here we are, finally. It's like a little TV. It's a little camera.
Eggs.
This is kind of the tutorial area. It's kind of just telling you what everything is. These are like cash. Would you say, Jenna? Like cash? Like monies?
It's equivalent to the monies.
You kind of get given it. Oh, actually, no, you don't ever get given money. You give money to other people for these.
Exchange for goods and services, yes.
A grab zoomer. Yeah, and it saves the game whenever you get one, which is convenient.
Yeah, you get to see him breakdance.
So, as I said before, this is actually our favourite Jak and Daxter game, although I think a lot of people actually prefer the second and third one.
What?
I know.
That's unspeakable.
Jenna,
that's a lie.
Jenna seriously hates the second one. I'm okay with the second one. It's not as good as this one by a long shot. But it's as platformers go on the PS2, it's not too bad. The third one's actually better than the second one, but not as good as this one, I don't think. These little guys, you just collect them to give you another power cell. It's like I've done this before.
The sound of the police. Butterfly.
Butterfly.
Blue Eco, which contains the energy of motion. Blue Eco allows you to run fast, break boxes, and even activate some precursor artifacts when you get near them.
So this game was actually a bit of a technological marvel when it first came out, because it had no noticeable loading screens between areas. There's just one big world. Obviously this bit does have a little bit of a loading screen because you went for a teleporter, but as you're walking around the main world, there is no sort of stop and wait kind of stuff going on. It's generally just a go through the little wall or something, go through a little tunnel when you're there without any kind of noticeable loading. There is obviously noticeable, there is obviously loading in the background, but you can't notice it. I made that.
That's perfectly clear. Made that clear. It's noticeable, but not noticeable. Question is, how did they manage that? Was it just the technology of the time was more advanced?
They just, well, they just managed, they found a way to hide them. If you kind of, if you think about it, it's kind of, I'm no game developer, but as you go into a new area, there's always what I like to call a pipe level, which is like a little section between the areas, and I think the loading takes place between there. I'll show you what I mean.
Okay.
I'll show you what I mean when we go out to the main area. Also, those doors are a good way of hiding it as well.
But even then, wouldn't there be a pause?
Exactly.
It's pretty seamless either way.
Yes, it's good, isn't it?
I mean, I'm no game developer, but it's pretty impressive.
So that was the thing back then.
Those little green balls of energy on the ground are a type of eco. Pick up 50 small green ecos or one
green ecos. So you've actually played this before, haven't you?
I have indeed. You don't believe me, but yeah. I beat the game with a friend.
Apparently she beat it with one of her old girlfriends, but I don't know.
Someone's a bit skeptical about my skills. And why is that?
Why am I skeptical?
Mm.
Because
did I make it out to be a lot harder than it was or something?
Yeah, you did. When we played for all three, well, we played all for all five of the games, or four of them at least. I was watching you play through this one, and you were just struggling like no one's business. And then I played it, and I was like, what the hell was she struggling about? But I did think maybe it was to do with the fact that I'd seen you do it. I don't know. I don't know.
Possibly. We'll never know. Never know.
He's got the moves.
We got the moves, Jack. We got him.
He's got the moves like Jagger. His little bird.
I know, he's so cute. It's like he has a third eye.
Why don't you make yourself useful? My darn green eco collectors are closed up again.
I have to do chores.
Head out to the far side of the beach and clear them out, why don't you? Follow the lamps. They take you right there. Now, all of you, get out of here!
There's the little piranha plant.
Yeah, from Crash Bandicoot. Well, you reckon it's just from Crash Team Racing, but he was in Crash 1.
That's where I'm most familiar.
Although he is
with.
Kind of, he is purple.
It's not good pedantic.
In the original Crash Bandicoot, he is kind of, whoa, where am I going?
Why are you trying to kill yourself?
I don't know what's happening.
Do I need to take the controller and show you how it's done?
Just got a little bit lost. So, yeah. So each area basically gives you certain things to find. Basically, there's, how many is there? So it does give you a list of what you need to find. There's eggs, like how many eggs here. It says there's 50 eggs to find, we haven't found any. There's six, what I call power orbs. And there's seven fly things. 112
in total. But it's a lot of stuff to collect.
We'll get there, don't you worry.
Will we?
Yeah.
So is this the pipe you're talking about?
No, I tell you what I mean. Actually, if I would have carried on going, it would have been the pipe. Okay. But think of this place as the hub. So this is like the hub. So think of it as like a, what's one of the, like a brainstormer, right? So you put in the middle idea, and then you string off of it, right?
Mm-hmm.
So think of the middle section as not idea, but as the hub. So what happens is when you walk through this area, right? It says forbidden jungle. You got this section here that's not really anything. There's nothing here. So this would be the line. So what I think it does is loads up a little bit here, and then by the time you get up there, it's loaded up the rest. So it looks seamless, but you know, we're not going to go that way yet, though, because we don't need to go that way yet. That's for future.
Future.
I think that's how it does. Because also, if you go to the volcano place, the pipe then is the little road, the little
steps and stuff up there.
The step? No, not necessarily. I guess the steps would be, yeah. Yeah, because if you got the steps, yeah, but it leads to that area with the bike. Remember, across the lava.
Yeah.
Heading towards the volcano. I'm chucking him in, aren't I?
Can I
do it early?
Talk to him in.
One's in already.
Gotta milk those yak cows. He's even doing the gestures.
Just resting my tired bones. I've been trying to get those hungry yak cows back into the pen all day. Some strange creatures tried to steal them earlier.
Maybe his legs wouldn't be hurting so much if he wasn't carrying around all that straw. It's not necessary.
He's got to feed the cows. Yeah, so he's bringing in the crops.
Oh.
For something, I don't know. I don't know what he said, but...
Get in there.
Yeah, so this is good evidence, actually, to you making this level a whole lot harder than it was. When you were using these cows, you were just punching them, so they were going all over the shop.
Because I didn't know that punching was direction. I thought punching them would be get in your home. Go to your home. Go where you belong.
They're animals. I don't respond well to...
Rule with the iron fist.
So pain. Like Margaret Thatcher, you are?
Yep.
So you just... Stay right behind
Look
him.
Look how much everybody loved her.
Hey, get in there.
Say punch. You need to punch him sometimes.
Yeah, get back. Well, you were punching him every second.
Yeah,
didn't stand a chance.
Well, speed up the process.
Do, 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 do.
That lazy farmer owes us a pallet sound. Let's go talk to him.
Let's get these eggs first. Because we need these eggs to get more power cells.
Hmm.
Yeah, see?
This is a pipe.
Yeah, pipe to the next area. See, not much going on, and then you're there around that corner. You're at the level. That's how I think it. I'm not a game developer. We could speak to Ryko maybe, and he'd tell us. You know, maybe Ryko has the plans. Or you could probably just watch a making of video, which there probably is one around, and they'll tell you how they did it. But that's. Oh, we could ask, what's his name? Andy. My friend on Twitter. Andy, what's his name? The guy who made the game. The co-founder of Naughty Dog. He replied to me when I spoke to him about Jak 2 being poor.
And what did he use as his excuse?
He just said that the game needed to grow with its audience.
Invisible wall.
But I don't think that's true. I think there was an audience. I don't think this game was directed at kids. I don't think this game was just played by kids when it came out, so I don't really understand that argument.
Because I think I would have been in high school when I played it, and I don't really...
I still reckon, although he won't admit to it, I reckon. Influenced by GTA. GTA 3 came out, open world was awesome, everyone loved open world, everyone was trying to copy that idea.
Mm.
I reckon that's what happened.
That's a theory.
Come here, you little bugger. Oh, he's got a helicopter in his house.
A helicopter in his house?
One of those little flies. I always see them as little helicopters, but they are flies.
Ah, well done, my boy. You actually got back into the pen. Now I can sleep in peace. Take this parachute
out of
your trouble.
Thank you.
Gimme.
He's sleeping again.
Didn't take long.
Doing break dancing. Okay. Now we should also have enough. Yeah, I do. For the one from my uncle.
Hooray! Your uncle.
May I have to talk to this woman as well?
Why not? Thought she had a tail then.
Well, she's got a bird costume on.
Could be.
Yeah, she has like two eyes, a beak, and a little feather.
Yeah, so it could be a tail then.
Yeah.
Just melt the egg.
What I also don't like about the future games is the complete negligence towards these characters. No, none of these characters appear again.
It's fine, it's not like they're in the village where you grew up or anything.
Yeah.
Your uncle.
Hello there, my dear boy.
Hello.
The most innovative moment. I was to set off on my journey yesterday, but I seem to be a spot short on the old precursor orbs. I would have pledged my word
scratchy.
90 of them. But I gather that your young friend...
He doesn't have enough toes. It's freaking me out.
You just missed him. Insult him. Don't talk over the cutscenes.
Anyway, would you be kind enough to loan your dear old uncle 90 precursor orbs so he can get underway? I would offer you a power cell in return.
So we'll never hear it now. What was his insult? We won't know. Because little jennabunnykins was chatting away. Probably about Sex in the City or something.
I see you two are back to make the trade. Good, good, jolly good. Hey, you have the precursor orbs that we agreed on. I hope you put this hard-earned power cell to good use. Cheerio, ta-ta, bye-bye.
Cheerio, ta-ta, bye-bye.
He always telling me that I don't talk enough, and I don't talk loud enough, and then when I do talk loud enough and talk over him, then you get mad at me.
You have to realise that the sound of the game is coming from this microphone, so if we're talking over the cutscenes, they ain't going to be able to hear what's going on. You muffin head.
Clearly everyone wants to hear me talk.
No.
Come on.
They want to hear the mayor talking.
It's not talking.
Yes.
We have eyes. The eco beam coming from the jungle. Why is that in his house?
Boys, everyone's too frightened to go out and find out what's happened.
Did you pay the bill?
Yeah. Oh, you're funny. Now look.
Okay.
If you two fix the eco beam, I'll give you a power cell. Oh, and another thing. By any chance you're interested in making a contribution to my re-election campaign, I might be willing to part with yet another power cell. Minimum contribution is a very modest 90 precursor orbs.
We don't have 90 at the moment.
Hmm.
Let's move on. See, if it had subtitles, then it'd be fine to talk, because you can kind of...
Alright, I get it. I done wrong. I'll stop. Just leave it alone. Better.
There's a thing down here. Where is it? There it is. Fly. And there's another one. Woo! Now we can go and talk to Keanu Reeves. Oh no, the turtle from Finding Nemo.
Get it right.
Get it right. Well, Keanu Reeves kind of talked like that. It's just not as deep.
Little dude.
Little dude.
Oh, I thought for a moment you were my muse.
Your what?
Haven't you ever seen a muse before? It's a little glowing squirrel about your size, full of spunk, and crazy as a lark.
Oh, I get it. Like a sidekick.
As a matter of fact, without my muse, I just can't sculpt. But with her around... I see beauty in everything, you know? Right now, I couldn't chisel my way out of a box. I think she ran away to that misty island. Oh, I just hope she's all right. It's worth a power cell if you bring her back to me.
Wait a minute! We are not going back to Misty Island! Are we?
I think we are. But not in this chapter, bro. Not in this chapter, not in this part, because that's the end of that part, because that's part 24. No, it's not.
This is the first part, are you drunk?
24 minutes.
Okay, let's end the part here.
Thanks all for watching, guys.